the idea of this brochure would be, once it's done, that anybody can pick it up and know exactly. It's more like a, what I call, you know, those books, books for dummies. If you want to, how to use a computer, they used to have books for dummies. So, and we all need it. And this is this brochure will take you step by step exactly as to what you have to do. Indeed, it is also applicable to other citizens who may not necessarily contest elections, but they also want to know, what do my candidates do? What do they have to comply with? So it's a general reinforcement, not just of the information, but also reinforcement of knowledge within society at large. And unfortunately in Fiji, we've always had a dearth of it. Even with journalists, we find they do not necessarily have a good understanding of what the laws are or what the laws have been. So you need to be able to have the right information as a candidate, as a citizen, and even as a media person to know exactly what are the requirements. For example, we had a journalist who asked the other day, they said, oh, will they announce the date of the elections, you know, 2 days before or 3 days before? It's quite clear, it's in the Constitution. They simply need to read the Constitution. It says, His Excellency the President must announce the date at least 60 days before. So all of us in Fiji will know exactly 60 days before on what specific date the elections will be held. So this is the whole focus of this brochure. It has given us confidence to enter into this relationship, this partnership, with FNU, because it is critical to know that the academics who will be working on it are apolitical, that they will be objective. They're not contesting in some political party themselves. They're not going to politicize the issue. And I think, unfortunately, we have not had that again in Fiji, where you have independent persons who carry out independent analysis, not just in private, but also in public. And I think that's very critical. I'd like to acknowledge Professor Richard Herr, who's been coming to Fiji, is now part of FNU, is from University of Tasmania, and he has done a lot of work, and it was actually at his instigation that this whole process got kicked off. So the confidence we have in FNU stems from the fact that there will be objectivity in terms of gathering the information. It's not a political, a particular political proclivity, but it is in fact an apolitical approach to the gathering of information and presenting that information in a very independent and objective manner to the would-be candidates and, of course, to general members of the public. There's a lot of talk about transparency and credibility and you know, openness, etc. These are some of the things that is utterly critical. This forms part of transparency, because transparency also means having the right knowledge, having the correct knowledge. This morning, a few hours ago, I was talking to some potential donors, because we think it's a good idea to, for example, train people up who may become members of parliament. You know, there are many people who would be contesting the elections, they'd probably be first time members of parliament. So, what are the rules of the house? What do you do when the speaker comes in? Do you sit up? Do you stand down? Do you lie down? What do you do? What happens when a minister presents a bill? What is first reading? What is second reading? Many people do not know this. Many people who would become candidates would not know this. More so, many people who may become members of parliament may not know it at all. Of course, there are some people who were previously members of parliament still do not know it. So the point is that this is whole, the whole process, and this is what the Bainimarama government is focused on, and that is to ensure that whilst we talk about these types of issues in the general space, we need to be quite specific in terms of arming people with the right knowledge. So this is another project that we are looking at and joining up with a potential donor and potential partner to ensure that when the new parliament does come in, the people who've been elected, they know exactly what information is required to become candidates. And once they become elected, once they become members of parliament, they go in on the first day of parliament. It's not like they walk in and they don't know what to do. They should be able to know exactly what to do. They should know where they're going to sit. who speaks first, all those types of things we hope to put in another brochure. Maybe FNU could look at doing that type of work, but we'll see. So I'd like to thank very much the words of the Shadow Affairs from the Japanese Embassy. I'd like to also thank him publicly for him, his embassy here, his government, and of course the people of Japan for this wonderful contribution they made and the collaboration with FNU. We are sure that this brochure will be beneficial to many people, as has been highlighted, will be translated into the Itaoke language, in Hindi, and of course it will be in English too, and it will be for wide dissemination. So thank you once again to FNU, and of course the Japanese Embassy.